On October 20th, 2021, dozens of astronomers gathered near Las Vegas. They pointed their telescopes at the sky and waited for the moment that the light from a faraway star blinked out. It was an event so minuscule, it would have been easy to miss. Yet the data gathered by scientists from those few seconds helped contribute to the success of NASA's Lucy mission. As the astronomers observed the star, it appeared to blink out as asteroid Eurybates passed in front of it. Eurybates is one of seven Trojan asteroids Lucy will visit over the next 12 years. The Trojans are clustered in two swarms that orbit the Sun at the same distance as Jupiter, though they're as far away from Jupiter as they are from the Sun. These asteroids are remnants of the early solar system, and by analyzing them up close, scientists can hone the theory of how the planets formed and ended up in their current locations. As Eurybates eclipsed the star, a phenomenon scientists call an occultation took place, whereby a shadow the size of the asteroid passed over the region. The best known example of an occultation is a solar eclipse, which occurs when the moon passes between the sun and earth, blocking the sun from our view. Leading up to the occultation, astronomers predict the asteroid's shadow's path across Earth and set up dozens of telescopes along a line that's perpendicular to that path. Spread out under the asteroid's shadow, they count the seconds the starlight blinks out as the asteroid passes in front. Using the asteroid's known velocity, it is possible to calculate its width. By observing multiple occultations of the same asteroid, scientists can catch different sides of the asteroid and combine their two-dimensional silhouette projections into a three-dimensional shape model. Observing an occultation is one of the most reliable tools scientists have to gather information about Lucy's target asteroids and prepare for flybys of each of the mission's targets. The team will continue to observe occultations until Lucy's last flyby of Patroclus in 2033.